Hey guys, this is Modern Pioneer again with a really cool video this time. I'm going to be focusing on this grow out cage that I just finished and after testing for a couple weeks just to make sure I can tell you any tips and tricks I learned along the way. I'm finally ready to present this thing. So if you like what you see, stay tuned and you can see start to finish. Let's go. To start, I've just laid out my 2x4s and kind of just getting an idea what I want this thing to look like. I'm going to be doing my best to use all the scrap material I have laying around the house. I went out and picked up some 2x4s. The store didn't end up paying full price because they were warped or some had more knots in it than they, you know, should. So I got them at a slight discount. Basically what I'm trying to say, if you can save money, this is a project you can definitely do it on. So I have some leftover galvanized roofing sheet metals from the when I did the raised garden beds, and then I'm gonna use this junk 2x4. So I've laid it out. I'm gonna get my length off my longest piece of the sheet metal, and then that'll be the longest length. So let's get cutting. Here we have it after about, I'd say, a solid day of working on it. The frame went really well, and then when I started to do the wiring for the quail side of it, it really started tacking on the time. But all in all, it's coming together really well. I didn't really expect it to be this big when I started. It's just whatever. I wanted to just get the most out of the wood that I had, and just decided to go with bigger. So I'm going to end up having three doors on each side. So one, two, and then three. And then I'm going to have like little rail in between each doors with a very small strip of the galvanized roofing sheet metal to help prevent water from getting down in there. Not that it really matters, but that's what I'm gonna do. So on this side right here is gonna be rabbits. We're gonna have a rabbit grow out cage. One important thing with rabbits is they like to dig. So if I did an enclosure like this, just like the quails, without a bottom, the rabbits will dig out from underneath. So I got some like half inch chicken wire that I'm just gonna, I measured it in just one solid strip all the way to the bottom. So for this side, all I need to do is do the chicken wire on the sides like this, and then the bottom of the chicken wire too. And then that'll be done. The quail side over here is just about done. It is done. I just need to do the the daggone roofing portion of it. So this center portion right here, I created this a little elevated right here. So you can see there's a little bit of a gap right here down underneath this 2x4. And the reason being is because I wanted to have the sheet metal overhang here and then the doors that are gonna uplift come in here. So, you know, I don't know. It's what I'm doing. So that's about it. What I'm doing to staple the chicken wire up here is I'm using some little roofing nails here. And then I'm also using some like stakes. Right here, just little U stakes, putting them in just to really just pull the wire tight and then, just secure it as best I can. I know some people say, you know, well, having a grow out cage at the bottom, you got to make it snake proof. Yeah, you know, I get that if you have those types of snakes in your area, and that is a problem, but fortunately for us where we are, we really don't have anything but like a garter snake, so we're set for now. So this is, we'll say, day one, and this is what we got. It's looking pretty good. It's going really good. This is just the process and what I'm doing for the doors. The doors that are going to be on top of the grow out pin. So I'm doing these frames. I am using my miter saw, not miter saw, but table saw. I'm using my table saw to mark each one the same width of the board and then do the opposite cuts there. I don't care how it looks. These are reusable or just junk boards that I'm just trying to get the most out of. So a couple of the ends do look ugly, but it's not because of my cuts, it's just because the wood was split or, you know, whatever. So this is what it's gonna look like, and then the aluminum sheet metal will be over top of it, and I'm gonna do threes. One, two, three, and then there's gonna be dividers in the middle of each one to help, you know, guide and direct the rain. Don't get underneath there. How I'm doing that with my table saw is after I've cut the wood to the length with my miter saw, I am running it through the table saw, getting it the same length, and then pulling it back with my relief cuts. So I run it through here, and then pull it back, run it through, pull it back, run it through. And it's all the same depth, so which is half the depth of this. And then when that's done, I'm coming over here, and I'm just with a chisel, just taking it all out, just from there. And then what I'm doing from there is taking it back over here and then just running it sideways like this. You got to be careful here because if you run into a knot or something when you're using this method, it can take the board. I've been cutting for a while and it hasn't happened to me because I know to look out for it. But, you know, if you try to do this method, you know, just be careful and look out for that. So that's what the finished product is gonna look like for the frames of each one of the six doors. Yeah, it's a lot. I'm kind of regretting it right now. Okay, for this process, I just wanted to show you how I'm doing it since, you know, I don't want there to be any confusion. You see after I use the chisel, there's a little bit of, it's rough. So how you get this smooth in and like, you know, with the knots and stuff in there, you may have that, but just how you get that smooth in, this is how you do it. So I'm going to use my table saw. I don't have a guard on, so just, you know, do this at your own risk, but I always just keep two hands on the board and then just very slowly work my way up the blade. So what you're doing is you're starting here at the lowest point, and every time I go all the way forward to the stop, then I'm just slowly working my way back, and then the teeth along the saw blade are taking it from the side. So that's before. After that actually turned out really good. Here's some junk wood. So that's how I'm doing it. Okay, I messed up. I got the doors done and I went to apply the hinges right here and notice that large gap. I hadn't figured out how close to the center I was gonna have it. I didn't know if I was gonna put my hinges here. I didn't account for the gap the hinges create so that they operate without a problem. So that extra space there in turn transferred out here. And you see this gap? That's no bueno because I'm putting the sheet metal over top So in essence, there'll be a little gap right here for, you know, whatever to get in. And I mean, I guess it's not really that big of a deal because we don't have a ton of predators around here, or, you know, if there were any snakes that wanted to get them, they'd just go in through the side. But my thing is I got that gap, and then this sticks out so much more than it should, and than I had intended. So what I'm trying to do now is what I'm going to do is fix it. So before the glue set up, I undid it, and then I lined it up with where the hinges are going to be, just like it was down there, about like that. And then I came and I cut my line here. So now all I'll do is just trim that out and then cut off the excess there. So a little bit of an inconvenience, but not the end of the world. And I just want to show you guys so you can just watch out for little things like that. So the end is in sight. It's definitely turned into a bigger project than I anticipated, but I only have myself to blame. I just, you know, what I've said before on this channel, if it's worth doing, do it once, and that's it. I don't ever want to come back and repair or do anything else with my projects. I want them to be done the first time, done right. So I tend to go overboard, but hey, I only do it once. So I ended up cutting the end of this flush with the lip right here, the frame, and it turned out really well. Definitely glad I did that. And I forgot, I had intended to put these locks on it right here. So if it wasn't flush right here, I would have had a hard time installing those. So over here, this one is done for the most part. Turned out really good. And then I just wanted to pause and show you guys just, you know, this left side is finished, and then to the right, what, you know, my progress. So right here, what I'm doing to catch the rain, I was debating whether to put mesh over the top, like right here, so I wouldn't have to do aluminum sheet metal, because you see it kind of holds it up right there. But you know, after thinking it over and everything, if I didn't cover that and just let more water go down there, it may really make it all wet and nasty in there for the animals. And I'd like to avoid that, because the idea of this is not to destroy your yard. It's supposed to be like a moving, you know, lawnmower thing, you know, for your animals. So then this side, next step right here is for me to just put the sheet metal over top there. And you can see right here, I didn't know how to hold this down because this is really sharp and I don't want anybody to get a cut on it. So I want to minimize all chances of that. I was debating whether to put these roofing nails with the little plastic caps, but wasn't really happy on that look. So then I decided to go for these 3/4 inch 14 gauge poultry net staples right here. And that works really well. I'm doing this with water flow in mind. So I want to minimize how many holes I put in here, and the holes I do put in, I'm using, I'm using the self-piercing roofing screws that have the, you know, the O-ring there to help waterproof it. So then I want to just create a seamless waterproof barrier. And then once all this is done, I'm going to put a single sheet of roofing material over top here, which will overlap here and then should hopefully cover these screws anyway, but we'll see. If not, you know, they are waterproof there. So that's how we are here. I'm gonna go ahead and finish this side and then work on putting the wheels on it. To move this thing around, I've got the wheel assembly that I made. It's super simple. You just go over here, grab here, lift up, and then it swings under, and that's it. So, and then it is extremely heavy, But with those wheels being the way they are, I mean, it's nothing at all to just lift it and move it back and forth. I mean, it's heavy, but hey, those wheels really help. So, all right, let's get this thing in the yard.
And that's it. So I've been using this grow out pen for about 2 weeks now. My wife and I, family have, and just want to give you this final video. Look how happy those little rabbits are. Can you see them? So we got the quail on one side and some rabbits on the other. They just love all that space to run around in. They're so cute. And those are Florida whites. So, so I'm getting distracted. All right, about this grow out pen. I've been using this, like I said, for about 2 weeks now, and I really don't have a whole lot of complaints. Like I've said before, I ended up putting netting on the bottom of the quail because when I pick it up, it creates too much of a gap there that they could get out. Now, if you're doing chickens or something, you might be able to get away with not doing that. But if you're gonna go to this extent and do a grow out pen like this, I mean, I would recommend putting a floor on both sides. That way you have the versatility to put whatever you want, you know, on down the road. The track, I only live on an acre of land, by the way. So right here is where we've been moving this grow out pen, and you can see, I mean, it's not killing the grass at all. And we have left it in one spot for, actually this spot right here, we left it in this spot for 3 days, and you can see, you know, it kind of left a spot there where the quail just were tearing it up, and we had a lot of rain, which didn't help. But all in all, I just took a rake, smoothed it out, and that'll come back no problem here in a couple days. Not like I have the best of grass anyway, but I don't really care about that. So, you know, if you do care about that, I mean, you can see it's fine. There's Charm. She's happy to have more friends. So one thing I would say, and this is an adjustment I'm gonna make on down the road when I can, is this bar right here is not a solid piece. That's 5/8 diameter all the way through. And what I had to do is get a spacer and then weld them together here. And I'm not even gonna give you a close-up zoom because, you know, I'm a terrible welder, but whatever. You don't follow me because of my welds. So what I would recommend is it's good now, but I'm trying to find a single shaft 5/8 diameter that would fit the wheels that I have there, so then it'll just be a little more durable and, you know, when I move it around, which it really doesn't prohibit me from moving it now, but it's just something to work on. Improve if you're going to do it from scratch. Think about that. I put the locks on all of them because, like I said, we got little ones who like to come around and get in here. I grinded down all of the edges that I could and I put them in, so hopefully no one will get cut on it, but there's still a possibility there. You know, you really got to watch that. If you've never been cut by sheet metal, it is nasty, so just be mindful of that if you're going to do this. This piece right here, I guess, is movable, fluctuates, whatever. So when I pick up the door, it moves along with it. So you can see I have a complete rain barrier over top of this whole platform. Rain barrier. I don't think we're going to use this in the winter, because in the winter is when we thin them out. But in the summer, you know, the rain barrier and sun barrier are your most important things. So this really not only helps keep, you know, a solid roof on it, but also it helps trap some air and then funnel it down in there, I'm sure. I mean, shoot, I'm no engineer, but I mean, you know, wind comes across here, gets trapped here, goes down. you know, so I'm trying to just keep these guys cool. I got them out here today, get them out of their cages, just because it is in the 90s today. So we got the rabbits over here and then the quail over here, and they are just loving it. What I guess some differences is, if what I just noticed is, this is chicken wire, and then this is, I don't even know what this is called, but I used this wire predominantly on the end when I ran out of this. And I would just recommend just doing all of this. Just buy a big, you know, 50-foot spool. I think I used about 30 feet. And the bottom here was 30 inches. So one solid strand at the bottom. So anyway, that's what I would recommend. One thing I could do differently or improve upon this design is the wheels right there. I already said I'm going to make that a solid shaft, just so it's a little more durable in the middle. It still works pretty good, but occasionally the two separate since my weld's so bad. But in addition to just getting a single shaft for that whole line, it is, like I said, really heavy. So, you know, if you don't want to struggle as much, which I do like to struggle, yeah, whatever. But if you don't, then you could easily just put another wheel base on the other side. So then all you do is lift up the one side like you've seen me do, and then go and lift up the other side. And then it's just like pushing a stroller on pavement. So easy, you know, especially if you're on a clean, smooth surface like my yard is. So it'd just be two wheel bases, you know, instead of one. It's just something to think about, and if that's, you know, something that you think would work best for you, then by all means, you know, give it a go. Let me know how it works for you. Well, guys, I appreciate your attention, and once again, just staying with me through another video. And next, I'm going to be working on a treehouse I've mentioned previously. This is going to be a beam for the treehouse. It's going to go up there. So that's my current project now. So stay tuned for that. And that's all for now. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope it helped you in your endeavors to become a modern pioneer. Be safe.